Jan actually did the presentation yesterday, but I'm here today. So welcome. Thank you for joining us. I wanted to have this session to give you all a sense of what we heard from the faculty technology survey, which we did in January of this year. There were a few reasons for asking the questions that we asked in January. One, we wanted to get a sense of what CityU instructors are using their cell phones for, in particular, or mobile devices, when it comes to teaching CityU courses. So we know that instructors, you know, probably checking email and doing that sort of thing, but we wanted to know how they're interacting with students. And we got some interesting answers. So we asked a series of sort of multiple choice questions and also some open-ended questions. And I would say the open-ended ones were a lot more illuminating, which is perhaps common. It was interesting to go through and read what I imagine are some of your responses. So thank you for everyone who took the opportunity to complete that survey. It was very, very helpful. And I wanted to let you know that we heard you, and we are making adjustments and changes and sending out information accordingly. So that's kind of the basis for this session. So what we'll do in this session is I will share with you what we heard about CityU instructors' mobile technology use based on the faculty survey. I'll also share how these survey results will be used to improve services, and also what training resources we currently have available. So I think that it is common for even, you know, for myself and others to come to have a question or have something that you want to do in a course and be kind of stumped and come to find out there is training available, like, but on e-learning's website or on the help portal or on the library website. So I want to point out a couple of those locations and a couple of those resources and people if you don't know them already. So first of all, just kind of a high level snapshot of what we heard. We sent the survey out to around 650 teaching faculty and heard from 109, so we were very happy about that response rate. You can see that, well, you may or may not be able to see, actually, because I realize that this is a very dense slide, but on the left, the red color are mixed mode, so in-class or mixed mode instructors who do their majority of their teaching in mixed mode or in-class. Of course, that's a little bit misleading because mixed mode and in-class are put together. In any event, the online only is about 41%, and then there is 6% of performance-based. So just a couple of highlights then on the right side. These questions, and I'll call your attention to them and read them, and if you can't read them. It's asking instructors to rate the importance of being able to do these certain tasks on their mobile device. We're assuming phone. We actually did not separate out tablets because tablets provide a more similar experience to the laptop, still sort of in between, of course, without the keyboard in many cases. Anyway, you'll notice that I think these arrows are a little bit, view course media, such as videos, add or modify course content, grade student work. These are things, and respond to student assignments. These are things that instructors said are important to be able to do on a mobile device, which was interesting that as many instructors said that it was important to be able to respond to student assignments, even grade student work on a mobile device. Now you can also see that it's not like everyone said that it was very important. The dark red is extremely important, then orange is very important, and so on down to not at all important. So you can see some big splits, but we were still interested to see as much interest in being able to do these sorts of things on a phone. Before I get to that, secondly, we wanted to find out what people's experiences were on site in the classrooms. So we, as I went back and looked at the results, which were all anonymous, I could at least see what sites, what locations had certain issues at the sites. So that's one sort of avenue for us to get at that information, what we can do to improve classroom sites. Overall, people who, the blue is not applicable, so I'm imagining that those are a lot of online-only instructors who projector, audio, smart board, et cetera, are not applicable. There were many satisfied folks, some dissatisfied, and a few very dissatisfied, and it's for those that the open-ended questions were so invaluable. So getting kind of a sense of what it was about the projector or the audio that was not acceptable. And I'll get to some of those things in a minute. So back to the, I think one of the main key points, back to instructors saying that it was very important to be able to do this sort of intensive student feedback, grading, et cetera, on a phone, there was quite a significant gap between what instructors rated as important to be able to do and what they currently do, which is not to say that it's not important, but I think that something that came up over and over again is the Blackboard mobile apps, and that is something that CityU has some but limited control over. So one something that we plan to do as a result of this feedback is to just make sure that we stay abreast of all of the Blackboard mobile app updates, versions, investigate national university systems, availability of the various tools in Blackboard, and make sure that we're making the best, most functional and rich versions available. Another key point is that despite instructors saying that these certain activities were very important to be able to complete, the majority of written comments emphasized the limitations of the phone for most instructors and a preference for the laptop. There were definitely big exceptions to that, but the majority of the written feedback that we heard really said, you know, I love my laptop, I work at my desk, the small screen and the lack of the left navigation and the Blackboard mobile would, you know, I can't type well enough or, you know, really give students adequate feedback that way. Another key point we heard is just the Blackboard mobile app, its limitations. And I think that some of those limitations are perhaps the particular app that they've developed. Part may be, is it realistic to be able to grade 20-page papers on the phone? That's an open question that I'm not answering, but that was feedback that we got, that the mobile app that Blackboard provides is limited in terms of what instructors feel comfortable doing. Also, wireless issues at CityU sites is something that has come up in this survey and also in one that Information Technology sent out. And I know that is one thing that is being addressed on the site level. I know that that the IT department is following up on their study as well, their survey as well, and addressing the wireless issues at some sites. Also, I wanted to, I will show you in a minute some documentation and training on CityU supported technology tools that already exists and also that is updated. So just because you don't see a topic there now doesn't mean you can't suggest it, and we would be happy to add pages, add information on how to find things. I can at least speak from a library perspective that we kind of try to balance it, providing enough tutorial content with information overload and creating detailed screencasts that people may or may not sit through. So we've actually found that having a document with some screenshots is sometimes even more effective and more used. So kind of trying to find that balance. But we're always interested in learning about what instructors particularly have questions about. Also, a lot of you I know do create screencasts. So when you capture what is on your desktop and speak over it, so to demonstrate a math problem or to give an introduction to your students with your video image in the corner while you show them the Blackboard environment or whatever. Screencast-O-Matic is one tool that a lot of folks use for creating screencasts, and the library has purchased a number of Screencast-O-Matic licenses that we will be making available in the next week or two. So look for an email from me about that. We would like to make that Screencast-O-Matic tool available to everyone who wants it. And it's actually a free tool, but what the licenses are is to the pro version, which allows unlimited length of screencast. It gives you editing tools. It removes the little Screencast-O-Matic watermark. So it's a nice thing if you're planning on doing much editing once you're done with your video, and it's very intuitive editing. I mentioned the staying abreast of the Blackboard mobile. We're also investigating Kaltura. Well, we're currently using Kaltura in Blackboard, and there's a feature in Kaltura that is called Channels that will allow us to share multimedia content, video, by program or by course a lot more effectively. So we're working toward activating that feature in Kaltura. Currently, as some of you may know, we have video here, video there, some on YouTube, some on Vimeo, some on Kaltura, some on a streaming server. So what we are working toward is a way that we can kind of consolidate and manage the video that is created at CityU. And lastly, we will be addressing site-specific needs, one example being for connecting remote students into live classroom sessions. We have heard that there are sort of impromptu, students joining a live session, a live class, and the instructor is not feeling confident in the equipment that is available at the site. So we'll look at the equipment that's available at the sites, and we will also kind of draw up a simple instructions on how to get started and what the recommended way to patch students in might be. And that's actually an interesting distinction of the kind of the recommended and supported CityU supported tools and resources. So we're certainly not discouraging someone from trying out a tool that is not one of the ones that is fully supported by e-learning or by the library, certainly not prohibiting students connecting to class any way possible, but we do want to kind of make that distinction of what we can help you with from start to finish, and not. So let me show you some examples. First of all, on the student portal or faculty portal at my.cityu.edu, if you click on Help and look for the e-learning section under Blackboard Resources, you will see a section on Blackboard Collaborate using web conferencing and virtual meeting space that is very helpful for you to get started with using web conferencing in your class. So Blackboard Collaborate would be the preferred platform for getting everyone in your class online together because it's built right into Blackboard. And also I just mentioned Kaltura for managing video and uploading video that you might want to share with your class, maybe something that you created on Screencast-O-Matic, for example. So Kaltura direct instructions and guides are also available on the faculty portal. So check out the faculty portal, and this is a resource that the e-learning team is, these resources are constantly being updated and adjusted as things change. They're fantastic about that. So this is something that I look to all the time. Second, actually. These are our e-learning instructional designer and design support staff. So if you have specific questions about creating course content that is has multimedia or that uses tools in Blackboard or Kaltura, Collaborate, Whitney and Brian would be happy to help you as you design your course. I also wanted to point out the library website has under how-to guides. Well, the library website is at library.cityu.edu, and we have a how-to guides section that has tutorials on various library resources, research databases, how to use APA style, program-specific guides, and also one on academic technology. And you'll see Blackboard Collaborate, and if you're looking for Microsoft software, guidelines for different resources, technology standards, what we're asking students to have in order, you know, in terms of their computer and audio capabilities if they're an online student. This is a place that houses a lot of that information. What you see circled is free tools for teaching and learning, and this is where we have, it's a list of resources that CityU fully supports, and we're happy to walk you through and help you integrate those in a way that makes sense into your course. And I'll show you that website in a minute. On the right side, you'll see other tools that faculty use according to the faculty survey, and this was just another really interesting way for us to get feedback and ideas of what you and what instructors are using in courses at CityU. And you can see Grammarly, iMovie, Padlet, Weebly, there's a whole host of tools. And certainly explore as you like. These are tools on the right that CityU doesn't fully support. But let me show you the library website. This is still coming. So under academic technology, could really be called tools for teaching and learning. So at the top we have recording tools. So I mentioned Screencast-O-Matic. Also Audacity is something that a lot of folks use for recording their just audio and adding that. Kaltura, Vimeo, YouTube, Prezi and Trello are really good for group work. Well, Prezi is for presentations, and Trello is kind of a project management light product. Meeting tools. So take some time to look at this page and also the e-learning site and see if there are any tools that really seem to speak to needs that you have in your class. There's a polling tool. There's also polling available in Collaborate, which is quite easy. SurveyMonkey is actually how we administered the faculty tech survey that started out this presentation. So those are some resources that currently exist, and we're always happy to create more as needed. And I do want to mention again, look out for the email about the Screencast-O-Matic licenses that will become available to instructors. And secondly, the quarterly emails that come from the e-learning department before each quarter are always jam-packed with really, really useful information and updates about the Blackboard and how to effectively teach. So those are great. So thank you so much for attending. I wanted to, above all, just say that we have been very interested to get some of the feedback and sort of finding out who needs what at different sites and fully online folks. And we will definitely be using that feedback to improve the services that we provide to you. So please let me know if you have any questions. You can type into the chat box at the lower right. Just look for the little bubble icon. And I am happy to answer any questions that you might have.